penny for your thoughts.
There's nobody there.
Miss Manning, these drawings of yours, just like all the others, are of little use to me, if none. It's like sending my men out chasing after their own chef.
I'm sorry, that's the best that I can do.
All right, then let's go over it one more time, huh? Now, neither you nor your friends saw him in this underground parking lot prior to you getting in the car, is that correct?
My friends were not
and
in
nobody.
The underground parking lot.
No, wait a minute. Nobody saw him, did they, after you had your little accident?
He was there. He was in the car.
Sure, he was there. Just like last time he was there. You remember you called us? You said he had followed you home and he was waiting outside, which he wasn't.
By the time your men had gotten there, he'd gone.
Maybe it was a little bit more like the time before that. I think it was an art supply store. That's right. You had the manager call us something about a man in dark glasses watching you through a window, wasn't it? And he wasn't watching you at all, was he? No, in fact, he wasn't watching anybody, and we cops catch hell for rousting a blind man. How about that? And who would forget the time before
Sergeant
that?
Sergeant Newman, I'm tired. I would like to go home.
Miss Manning, this may come as a complete surprise to you, but I'm tired. I'm tired, too. And I'd like to go home. Now, just a minute. In the last 36 hours, I've worked on 5 homicides, 3 armed robberies, and more cases of assault than you could count. And now I've got you and your non-existent bogeyman.
He exists.
Oh, yeah, sure. Hell, yes, he exists. You know where he exists? Right in your mind.
Open up, Sergeant.
Oh, boy. Mrs. Mann, here we go again.
All right, Dad.
Yeah, I'm fine, Mother.
Well, what happened? I mean, they told me you had an accident.
He was in the car.
The man again?
Except this time he spoke to me.
He spoke? What did he say?
Mrs. Manning.
He said, soon, Amy, soon.
Soon? What do you suppose that...
Mrs. Manning.
What is it?
Can I speak to you for a moment, please?
Mrs. Manning, I'm sorry. I don't think we can help your daughter. She needs another kind of help. I'm sorry.
All right. Come on, darling, let's get you home. Talk about it?
Do we have to?
I think we better. Sergeant Newman as much as said that if this kind of thing goes on any longer, the police will file a nuisance charge against you.
Against me?
They don't believe that man exists, Amy. You know that.
I know, I know. Everybody thinks I'm crazy.
Not everybody. I don't. question is, how do we convince the Sergeant Newmans of the world to take this thing seriously?
If only someone had seen him just once.
Amy, what would you think about our seeing a professional?
What do you mean, a shrink? I thought you said you believed me.
I do, but it seems
to... But nothing! Mother, I don't need a psychiatrist. I'm not crazy.
I know that, but the police don't. And it seems to me that if a psychiatrist or somebody like that went to the police and said that in his expert opinion what you were seeing was not just imaginary, they'd have to believe that the man was real and want to help. Wouldn't they? It's worth a try.
What would I see?
Well, the only professional I know is Dr. Letterman. He's not a psychiatrist, but a clinical psychologist is considered an expert. He teaches at the university.
Have I met him?
I don't think so. I've talked about him, though. He helped me during that period when I was drinking a little bit too much. And then, of course, when your dad died, he helped me through that. He's very easy to talk to.
Would you call him and see if he can set up an appointment for me?
I sure will. That's it, huh? That's all you can eat?
Why don't you get to bed?
Good night. Thanks, Mother.
Amy. It's going to be okay, you know. Say goodnight.
Gee, that's really coming along.
What do you think? Does she look like me?
Sure she does. I don't know. The nose may be a little off. What do you think?
Yeah, you're right. I was just hoping to get away with some cosmetic surgery.
Don't you dare. I like your nose just the way it is. Get some rest.
Mother. What do you suppose he meant? Soon, Amy, soon.
Try not to think about it, okay?
Cliff. Sorry I'm late. I got held up with a patient. How you doing?
Fine, thanks. It's a wonderful car.
Yeah, she's a 1930 Stutz. You like her?
She's a beauty.
Well, more of a beast, really, when you consider the mileage and the monthly payments, but I don't know. I just couldn't resist her. I think everybody should have one or two foolish extravagances in life, don't you? Well, fine-tuning that classic old motor car just happens to be one of mine. I seem to have a weakness for grease under my fingernails, my tragic flaw. What's yours?
Don't you know?
Well, Adele tells me that you're having some kind of a problem and that you might need someone to talk to about it. I don't know. I didn't really want her to tell me too much about it because I'd rather hear it from you. if that's okay. It's been proven that people with grease under their fingernails make very good listeners. So the only time he's spoken to you was last night in the car?
Yeah.
And all he said was?
Soon, Amy, soon.
Hmm. What do you suppose he meant by that?
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? Something's gonna happen to me.
Well, what do you think's gonna happen to you?
I don't know.
I mean, if he was gonna harm you, you sure had an ideal opportunity last night. He had you alone in the car.
No, but what if he enjoys frightening me first? You know, like a cat playing with a mouse? There are men like that, aren't there?
You think there are?
Well, yeah. I mean, sure there are. Not all men are like that, but...
Some men.
Anyway, he couldn't have done anything last night. We were in the street. There were people around.
Yeah, but none of those people saw him.
Well, there weren't a lot of people around. I mean, well... I don't know.
Do you mind if I smoke?
No, go ahead.
Tell me a little bit more about yourself. You got a boyfriend?
No, not right now. I was going out with this guy, Alan, but we broke up last year.
No one since then?
No. Well, nobody special. I've dated a few guys, but, well, I don't know.
Let's see now, your mother's dead. What about Adele? Two of you get along?
Oh, yeah, terrific. She isn't my real mother, but she's my mother, you know?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. Tell me about your father. Let's see, he died last year, didn't he?
Yes.
How?
Well, he drowned in a boating accident.
Oh?
Look, I don't know what this has to do with some nut out there that's trying to scare me to death.
Well, probably nothing. But maybe something. See, I think the point is you've given me some things to think about, and what I'd like to do is to get together with you again, maybe talk some more. What do you think?
Is there any point?
It's up to you. Tell you what, I'm going to give you my home phone number, and I want you to feel free to call me at any time. Anytime, day and night. Okay?
Yes, thank you.
Say hello to your mother for me.
You don't believe me, do you? But if you don't believe that he's real, nobody will. Not until it's too late.
Well, Amy... I believe that you believe this man exists.
That isn't what I asked.
I'm afraid it's the only answer I can give you. Sorry.
Amy Manning?
Yeah.
Have some flowers for you.
Oh,
sign
thank
in.
You. Wonder who could be sending me these.
Oh, there's probably a card inside. Have a nice day.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye-bye.
This man exists. Come on.
Hey,
this wreath to 14 Beekman Street this afternoon.
Sure. Well, Ralph did. Ralph does the deliveries.
But you took the order?
Sure, I did.
Could you describe the man who placed the order?
What is this, a gag?
Please, this is very important. Can you describe him?
Now, wait a minute. You want to play games? Go find yourself another playmate. I've got time for this sort of thing.
Wait,
really?
I don't understand. Why can't you just tell us who placed the order?
I suppose you're going to tell me you forgot.
What did she forget?
Now, look, lady, I don't know what she's trying to pull. She came in here not 3 hours ago, picked out the wreath, paid for it, and asked to have it delivered.
That's a lie!
Baby.
When you get out of here, I'll call the cops. What, are you crazy?
That's not true.
Good afternoon, Emily.
Good afternoon, Mr. Stockwood. Mrs. Manning's waiting for you in the study.
Thank you.
James.
Adele, you look lovely.
Thank you for coming. Would you like a drink?
Please. Pardon my lateness, but the office is bedlam.
It's all right.
Where's Amy?
She's upstairs in her room. She didn't know you were coming.
I understand you want me to speak with her. My secretary told me.
No, she misunderstood. It's about Amy. Something happened this afternoon.
Has she seen her phantom again?
Oh, James, she needs our help. And I don't know where to begin. She wrecked her car last night. She claims this man was in the back seat. He threatened her again. No one else saw it. The police think she's having a breakdown. I don't know. We had a scene with the florist today. I can't make either heads or tails of. He said that she had ordered this wreath.
I did not order that wreath.
Hello, Amy.
I did not order that wreath, Mother.
I know you didn't, dear. I just can't understand why the man said you did, that's all.
The man lied.
Why?
Amy, your mother is very concerned, and so am I.
So why aren't you out trying to find that creep?
It's not that easy. It's not easy at all. Well, we understand that you have a problem.
He is the problem. Find him.
What him? There is no him.
James, please.
Oh, I see.
No, you don't. You're the closest thing I've ever had to a daughter of my own. I was your father's best friend, not just his attorney. And for the trust of that friendship, as well as for your sake, I'm going to do everything possible to help.
That's all talk. I need you to help me, not just talk about it.
That's why I came here to discuss the problem with your mother.
You see, more talk. And the one person that you haven't bothered to talk to is me.
Perhaps a good talking to is exactly what you need, young lady. I know you're upset. So are we. Ever since your father's accident, you haven't been the same. I know it's not easy to lose someone, especially when you're as close as you and your father were. But we thought you'd overcome it eventually. But now this man appears. No one has ever seen him but you. Don't you think it's time we examine the logical explanation? That this man who's stalking you is a figment of your imagination. Don't you think we should admit that? Then maybe we can do something about it.
What do you suggest, an insane asylum?
Amy.
How about a lobotomy?
Amy, that's not fair.
Stay out of this.
Don't speak to your mother in that manner.
I'll speak to my mother in any manner I please.
While I'm present, you will not.
Please stop it, both of you. Where are you going?
To school. I have a class.
Not tonight, Amy, please.
I have a class.
I don't want you to go. Not by yourself. Not in the state you're in.
So call Sergeant Newman and tell him Matt Amy's on the loose again. Maybe he'll lock me up.
Before you leave.
Oh, okay.
Good night.
Good night.
What's the matter with you, you nuts or something?
Scare you. Are you okay? You dropped your keys in the street back there. I'm not a rapist or a mugger or anything, I promise. My name's David. David Norland. They don't make muggers named David. When I saw you running there, I thought you must be in some kind of trouble. But if you're okay, I'll leave you in peace. But I don't know what I'm supposed to do with your car keys. Venus Rising. Hello? Look, you don't have to tell me your problems. I won't tell you mine. But you look like you could use a drink. What do you say, huh?
I'd love one.
Great.
M'lady?
Shot out of that building like a cork out of a bottle. Didn't anybody ever teach you to look both ways before you cross the street?
Oh, I know, I know. I was just,
What?
I thought... Well, I got spooked, that's all.
Ah. Don't want to talk about it, huh?
Glad he didn't ask to see my ID.
Don't tell me I could be arrested for corrupting a minor?
Only for the next 3 months.
Well, drink slowly, then. I could be blowing my whole career.
What career?
I'm a lawyer. At least, that's what my diploma will say once I get it.
Well, you look too old. You look too old to be a student.
Oh, thanks a lot. What do you do?
I study art.
No kidding. You know, I remember in kindergarten, all the other kids would be sloshing finger paints every which way. And I'd be putting the lids back on the jars and arranging them in order of color. I blame my toilet training.
Well, speaking as an artist, I think you'd make a very good lawyer.
You're very perceptive. How about another brandy?
Oh, thank you. I'd like one. But I'd like to pay for it this time.
Definitely not.
Oh, no, I'd like to, please.
What, are you rich or something?
I can afford to buy you a brandy.
You really are rich. Will you marry me?
Well, I'd like to, but I have plans for tonight.
Oh, no, really?
I have to fix a nose.
What nose?
My nose.
What's wrong with your nose?
Not this my nose. It's a...
Oh, sure, I see. It's your nose, but it's really not your nose, I get it. Listen, are you sure you're not a little...
I am, believe me. You can ask anybody, I'm a crazy lady.
Crazy? Like how? You like to take off all your clothes and streak through MacArthur Park. You like to write mad, passionate love letters to Robert Redford 6 times a day. You imagine a tall, dark stranger following you. You... Whoa, I struck a nerve. What, Robert Redford? Not the tall, dark stranger.
Can we not talk about it?
Oh, sorry, I was on...
I know, it's okay, I'm sorry. I'll be back in a minute. Excuse me, okay?
Sure. Listen, let me tell you something. In my book, anyone who thinks they're going a little crazy is too much together for it to be true. Know what I mean?
Don't go away.
Not a chance.
Thank you.
soon. That's what he said to you in the car, isn't it?
I think he's gonna kill me.
Why do you think that?
He sent me a funeral wreath, didn't he? Rest in peace.
But the florist said that...
The florist was lying.
Why would he lie?
I don't know.
Okay. Let's just suppose for a minute, just for the sake of argument, that he wasn't lying. And that you, in fact, unknowingly, subconsciously, ordered that wreath sent to yourself. Now, what do you suppose that would mean?
Wait a minute, wait. I don't want to kill myself. I don't. Why would I want to kill myself?
I didn't say you did. It was just a question, remember? Just for the sake of argument. Okay, let's just talk for a minute about that boating accident your father had.
You want to tell me about it?
Well, there isn't a lot to tell. He went up to our cabin alone. He was fishing. He must have fallen somehow, knocked himself out on the side of the boat. He drowned.
Why did you say he was alone?
Well, I was supposed to go with him that weekend, but my boyfriend, Alan, and I, we went to Palm Springs together.
I see. Well, how did you feel when you heard about your father's death?
Do you mean, did it make me feel guilty because I hadn't gone with him?
Did you?
No. No, I don't think so. I mean, I couldn't help thinking that if I had been there, I could have done something, but I don't feel it was my fault.
You don't feel you were to blame because you weren't there to maybe do something?
Do you think I should?
Do you?
Why does this have to be so complicated? Why can't you just believe me? This man is real.
Amy, I understand why it's important to you that I believe that this man exists, but it's important to me that we explore all the possibilities. You see?
There's one that really concerns me. That's the possibility that somehow you feel responsible for your father's death and that you deserve to be punished for it. But because your morality won't allow you to punish yourself, you've invented a nemesis to do it for you. That's the possibility that worries me. Now, wait a minute, just hear me out, and then we can talk about it. You say that you don't want to kill yourself. Fine. But if I'm right, you won't have to. He'll do it for you. Can't you see? You have created your own executioner. Your subconscious has helped you to invent the perfect scapegoat. You won't leap off the top of a building to your death. You'll be pushed.
But if you're right, what do I do? How do I make him go away?
You've already taken the first step by admitting to the possibility. See, what you're going to have to do is to somehow exercise yourself of this guilt you feel. Let your conscious self admit how you really feel about your father, examine all the reasons for those feelings, and then either absolve yourself of the responsibility or accept the responsibility and forgive yourself.
But how?
Don't worry, Amy. We're going to find a way.
But he's so real. It's impossible. How could a figment of my imagination be so real?
Believe me, Amy, it's possible.
This evening. Do you need anything before I go?
No, thank you, Emily.
I'll be saying goodbye then.
Okay. Have a nice evening. Bye.
Thank you.
too hot?
Yeah. Mother, I think I should go away.
Go away? Why?
I could have killed you.
Amy, that was not your fault.
Whose fault was it then? You said yourself there was nobody out there.
Where would you go?
I don't know. Someplace where it's quiet, where I can think. Maybe the cabin?
The cabin? But you haven't been there since your dad died. I don't think that's such a good idea.
Why not?
I just think it's too soon, Amy. I know how you feel about your father's death.
Well, wait a minute, wait. Maybe that's the point. Dr. Letterman said that I should try and find a way to face my guilt about it. What better place than where it happened?
I just don't like it.
I'm gonna call Dr. Letterman.
Why?
I want to ask him what he thinks.
I don't like the idea of you going up there alone.
Hello? Dr. Letterman? This is Amy Manning.
Oh, Amy, hi.
Hi. I was just talking with my mother about maybe going away for a while.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Sounds like you found the right place to start. Mm-hmm. Amy, I told you we'd find a way. But now, it's all up to you. Something made you think of going up to that cabin when it was the last place that you wanted to go to.
Then just call me and let me know how you're doing.
Okay, I will. Thanks, Cliff. Thanks a lot.
Anytime.
He just said he wanted me to keep in touch and tell him how things were going.
All right. Would you like some company? I'd like to be there if you need someone to talk to.
You chop wood?
If you do the dishes.
I'll chop the wood.
That's what I thought. Oh, I'd forgotten how beautiful it is up here.
Yeah, Daddy loved it. Remember how he used to drag us up to the cabin on the slightest pretext?
All I remember is cleaning all that stinky fish. Yuck. Oh.
Nothing's changed.
No. Okay. It'll be dark soon. Let's change into our grubbies and get down to the lake.
These are my grubbies.
Oh, right. Let's get rid of these bags. No, no, save the groceries till later, huh?
Okay.
You're very quiet.
Oh.
What?
Daddy's boat wasn't still here.
Oh, Amy, it's just a boat.
The lake is sure a lot bigger than I remembered it. You know, even if I'd been here when Daddy was out in that boat fishing, even if he'd called out for help, what could I have done to save him?
Nothing, dear. Absolutely nothing.
I feel like a kid again.
You look like one.
Oh, thanks.
I don't.
El Blodo, right? Oh, what a mess.
Okay. I'll clean it up, Mom.
I remember when you first called me Mother instead of Adele.
So do I.
It was a big day for your dad and me.
When I first met you, I really wasn't sure about you.
Oh, yeah? Well, the feeling was mutual.
Spoiled brat?
Spoiled brat. I'd much blame you, though. I mean, you had your dad all to yourself for 10 years, and then I came along, the wicked stepmother.
But you know something funny? I can't even remember what it was like before you. I couldn't even imagine it.
Listen, go on to bed. I'll finish these up.
Oh, thank you. Night, Mom.
Doctor, let him in, please. When do you expect him in? Will he be calling in, operator? All right, tell him that a Mrs. Manning called. I'll try him again later anyway. Thanks. Talk to you for a sec, love.
Yeah.
You're up bright and early.
I've been up since 6 o'clock. Beautiful out here. What's up?
I just got off the phone with James. He wants me to come into town for a meeting.
Oh, what?
He said it was very important. It has something to do with the estate. I'm sorry, love. I'll get back as soon as I can.
Well, that's okay.
Thanks.
Sure.
Oh, Amy,
I'll be all right.
It's just so isolated up here.
Will you stop worrying? Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Get back as soon as I can.
Okay. Well, Mom, would you mind calling Cliff for me and telling him that I'm doing fine?
I sure will.
Okay.
Get some breakfast, huh?
Okay.
I'll see Mrs. Manning now.
I do.
I apologize for this, Adele. But it was unavoidable. Could it keep moving along?
No, it's all right.
Can I take your jacket?
We have to make it brief, though. Amy's expecting me. I don't want to be any later than I already am.
Certainly. Please sit down. The reason I insisted on your coming here today is we have some very important decisions to make, and time is running out. I needn't remind you that Amy's 21st birthday is only 3 months away, at which time she inherits her father's estate.
I do know that, James.
She assumes full control. You and I will no longer be the trustees. And that means you will have to rely on her for your income.
I should be able to live quite comfortably, I think. Admittedly, Walter wasn't overly generous in his will, but I've invested wisely thanks to you. I can't imagine Amy allowing me to want for anything, can you?
No, certainly not, under normal circumstances. But then circumstances aren't quite normal.
Go on.
I called Dr. Letterman the other day. He told me in confidence that it's possible she has suicidal tendencies.
He had no right to tell you that.
Perhaps not. But if she were to take her own life, after assuming control of the estate, it would be a calamity. We haven't even prepared her will yet.
This is morbid, and it's unnecessary. Amy is not going to take her own life.
Adele, this is the situation. I don't want to transfer an inheritance of such magnitude to someone as unstable as Amy.
Amy
is... If she were judged legally incompetent, then you and I would have to continue to administer
Amy
the estate.
Amy is going to be fine. Dr. Letterman has found a way for her to beat this thing, and she's going to. I know it.
Well, I certainly hope you're all right.
I am right. I'm sorry, James. I know we have to talk about these things. It's just not easy, that's all. Oh, I have to get going. Traffic's going to be terrible this time of day.
Yes. I'll speak to you later.
That'll be fine.
Goodbye.
Bye.
It's me. You don't have to worry about Adele. She just this minute left. She can't possibly be back until well after dark.
Good, very good. It's down by the lake sketching. Don't worry, everything's under control.
Hello? Dr. Letterman, please. Oh. No message.
Here you are, my love.
Brandy?
Yeah.
Well, Cliff, I...
No, it's all right. It's all right. I think you need it. Okay. The gun's clean. I reconnected the telephone. Got the blanks.
Where were you today?
What?
I tried calling you. Where were you?
Why?
Just wanted to know where you were.
No, I mean, why did you try calling me?
Because I wanted to talk about things a little bit more, that's all.
talk about it. What's there to talk about? Dell, we've been over this over and over again.
I had a meeting with James today. He bought it. He bought it all. He even talked about having Amy committed. I mean...
But what good would that have done? So they would have locked her up in an institution for a month or two, maybe even a year. She'd be out again. She'd be 21 years old, and the whole estate would revert back to her anyway.
No, I know.
Look, this way, you inherit everything.
I know. When we were up here alone together, everything seemed so different. I don't know why. I can't explain it. Maybe it was because I knew. She called me Mom. Not just Adele, not just Mother.
I know. I understand.
Oh, how the hell could you understand?
Now, hear me, Adele. She got between you and me and everything we ever wanted, just like her father.
Well, she's not anymore, Cliff. Because she's dead. Amy is dead. You took her down
to
that lake.
No, not me. We. We're in this thing together. We're in it together because we want to be together. It's as simple as that.
Oh. We're in this together because of the money.
No, my love. I wanted you. And you wanted me. But you got yourself trapped into an empty marriage with an impotent old man. And why, Adele? Tell me why. Why did you marry him? It was for the money. But what we did tonight, it was different. You wanted me more than the money. Isn't that right? It wasn't just the money, was it? It was me too. Now you say it. What we did for us. Come on, say it. We did it. Come on.
For us.
One more time. One more time.
For us. For us.
I gotta go.
No.
No. Forget. You mustn't even call me unless it's an emergency.
I'll miss you.
Take care.
You're there. I don't know what to do. I just got back to the cabin. Amy's gone. I can't find her anywhere. The boat's gone. Emily?
Emily, take this upstairs for Mrs. Manning.
Yes, sir. Is there any news, ma'am?
No, I'm afraid not.
All right.
You think she's dead, don't you?
I think we must be prepared for that.
Should never have left her alone. I knew it. I knew it.
You mustn't blame yourself.
She just seems so much better. James. Do you think she planned this all along? She couldn't have gone to the lake with the idea of joining her father, could she?
Dale, don't. You mustn't, please.
I'll be all right. It'll just take a little time, that's all. You have a lot of important things to do. Thanks for being there. Thanks.
I'll call if I hear anything. Anything at all.
Oh. Would you do me a favor and call Dr. Letterman for me? Tell him what's happened. I don't think I can face it.
Certainly.
Thanks.
Get some rest.
Hello? Yes? Oh, thanks. Hello, James. Any news? Oh, I see. But they've been dragging that leg for 2 days now. I know that. How long... I know. Oh, nothing. Thanks for the offer. I don't feel much like... leaving the house. James, would you call the minute you hear? Thanks. Bye-bye.
May I put these in your bathroom, Mrs. Manning?
Yes. I thought I asked you not to come into Amy's room.
I haven't, Mrs. Manning.
Then why was the door open?
I don't know. I'd swear I saw it was closed just a few minutes ago. I could be wrong.
let's just look what we really have here.
Someone leaves the door open. A hunk of clay is moved, and an alarm radio goes off. Come on.
I'd like another one, please.
Darling, please, you're not starting again.
Have a little brandy, my love, remember? If something, for God's sake, you got me locked up in that house all by myself. I'm not even supposed to call you. Waitress!
Look, drinking yourself into oblivion isn't going to solve anything. No wonder you're imagining things.
I'm not imagining things. That door was locked. That head just disappeared.
My love, there has to be a logical explanation. Maybe it was Emily. She knows you're upset. She probably put it away someplace so that you wouldn't start remembering things. Why don't you ask her?
I can't. She's got the rest of the week off. She's visiting some sick cousin in Idaho.
All right, then ask her when she gets back. You're bound to be a little overwrought. Why don't you just try to take it easy, calm down. We're okay. It's done. Okay.
You're overwrought, Adele. You're imagining things, Adele. Do you hear what you're saying to me? You're doing these things, aren't you? It's you. It's you. You're doing the same things to me that you did to Amy. Dare you? You are not going to get that money for yourself. You are not. Be quiet.
I can't inherit a damn thing. You know that. I mean, don't you think I'd at least wait until we were married before I'd pull a stunt like that? Come on.
That'll be $3. Thank you.
Find that body, I'd be okay. I know I wouldn't.
They will find it.
She's really dead.
Of course.
I mean, you actually saw her go under the water. She's dead. She's not alive and hiding out someplace.
Hiding out? Why would she hide out? She'd run to the police if she were alive, and we'd be in jail. She's dead.
Oh, God, I hope you're right.
I know I am. Now, in the meantime, you're just going to have to learn to be patient.
I'll try, I promise.
Good. Hey. Want some free advice? You gotta be doing something. You gotta keep yourself busy.
What do you suggest, needlepoint? A little spring cleaning?
Hey, wait a minute, you know, that's not a bad idea. Why don't you clean out Amy's room? Pack her stuff off. Might help.
All right, I think about it.
I've got an appointment. You gonna be all right?
Yes, doctor, thanks to you.
Hello. Hello? Hello?
Took you so long.
Take it easy. I had to park the car a couple of blocks away. I didn't want anyone to see it. What's going on?
I heard her. I heard her crying.
You don't mean Amy.
I heard her.
She's dead.
No, she's not. She's alive.
Darling, she's dead. She's dead.
Why the hell can't they find that body?
Because it's a big lake. Hey, don't worry. They're gonna find her.
It's fine. Come here. Come up. Come up with me. I want to show you something. Started packing away all of her things, just like you said.
What are you talking about?
Amy's alive. She's here someplace. She's punishing
Darling,
us for what we did to her.
Listen to me 1 minute.
She has to be alive. Who else would have done that?
I'd stripped the bed. There were boxes everywhere. Amy's alive. I know it. She's alive.
I packed away her paintings, everything.
Better answer it.
I don't want to.
Darling, you've got to.
Hello? Oh, James. No, I know it's late. It's all right. When? Yes. Yes, that'll be fine. Thanks for calling. At least the lake, they found Amy. James wants me to go up with him in the morning and identify the body.
Adele?
Oh, it's over. It's over.
It was her.
Yes, it's finally over. Oh. James is making the funeral arrangements.
Oh, my love. Everything's gonna be fine. You'll see. No more voices. No more dreams.
cliff.
No!
No!
You're supposed to be here. Why did you leave? I don't give a damn about appearances. You get here. You've got to get me out of here. It's Amy. She's come back. The head appeared beside my bed. Okay, I'll pack. But get here, please. Please hurry. I don't give a damn if anybody sees your car. You get here. Now!
Police are on the way. Sergeant, Mrs. Manning's husband, Amy's father, had confided in me he was certain there was another man. He was considering divorce, but before we could verify it, he had his boating accident.
So when all these things started to happen to the girl, you just naturally assumed...
Well, what other explanation could there be?
I see. So you connected Mrs. Manning with this Dr. Letterman character when you found out he had bribed this fellow at the flower shop, right?
Fortunately, loyalty often goes to the highest bidder, as with a certain florist and a certain mortician.
Yes, the less said about that little deal, the better. Now, I suppose you being a lawyer, you had very good reason for not coming to the police. Is that right?
Oh, we had no proof, Sergeant. I was afraid that you might consider me as crazy as Amy.
Right. And as for you, young man, you cut it pretty close, didn't you? I mean, actually letting him get that girl in the lake. A couple more seconds.
Tell me about it. By the time I'd figured out what was going on, it was too late to do anything else.
Well.
Oh, I suppose I don't have to remind both of you have to come to headquarters, okay?
We had no proof, David. We had to try to scare her into a confession.
Instead, we scared her into an execution.
James? What can I say? Thank you.
You all right?
I'm fine.
You sure?
Sure.
Thank you.
tell you why. For the money.
David, you scared the hell out of me.
Sorry, sweetheart.
What's the knife for?
The knife? Oh, here. Happy 2-month anniversary.
You nut. Well, what is it?
Go ahead and open it, see? Hey, look at that. Ooh, you saved it. You're almost back to your old self.
Almost.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Stop it. It's a keychain.
It's 18 karat, you know.
Yeah, what's the little pin?
That's so you can pin it to your purse so you can't lose your keys and have somebody else come along and find them. Now that I got you, I'm taking no chances.
Thanks, honey.
Hey, what are you doing up? I thought only lawyers work this late.
I dreamt about it again.
Oh, no.
This time, I could feel my lungs fill up with water, and he was...
Oh, shh. It's okay. Well, at least it isn't happening as often as it was before we were married.
Yeah, but is it ever going to stop?
Yes, it will. Just give it time.
You really think the nose is that far off?
Doesn't matter. I married you for your money, not your talent.
I thought thought you married me for my body.
That too.
Come on. Let's go to bed.
Okay. Let me just cover this up again.
I'll do that. You just get ready.
Okay. Don't be long.
Soon.